Hello YouTube viewers. Yeah, as you know, my name is Fifa Thomas. Welcome to another video. Yeah, today's video, I'm going to interview some African students, some international students here from Africa. But before we continue, please subscribe, like, and share. It is very important. Subscribe, like, and share. Yes. So guys, this student I'm going to interview right now, I'm not gonna mention his name, he'll mention his name himself. He has been here for 3 years, 3 good years. I'm gonna ask him some questions and then he's gonna answer. He will tell you his experience here in Russia. He has been here for 3 years and then he will tell you what he has gone through here. Okay, so man, how are you?
I'm doing great, man. I'm doing
okay,
great.
All right. So mention your name.
Okay guys, hello. So my name is Enoch King. I have been in Russia currently like for 3 years. I'm a student of software engineering. So like actually, I'm so happy like to be with Thomas right here, like to advise you guys about Russia and like my experience here in Russia and like how can international students successfully live in Russia. Don't go nowhere, like just keep around and you will have all the information that you need.
Okay, all right, you heard him. Yeah, he has been here for 3 years. How do you see Russia? In general, how do you see Russia?
For me, Russia like is the best place like for international students like to study in respect to the of finance, because like if I have to compare Russia with some like a powerful education house like the UK, I think if a student choose to study in the UK like or Canada like Australia, mm-hmm. is like it's going to ruin their and their parents' mm-hmm. yeah. financial life.
Yeah.
Whereas here in Russia, it won't take anything or like it's just going to and to be that normal fees mm-hmm. that he or she like is going to pay there in like Africa. It's, they will pay that same amount of like fees here and mm-hmm. like also gain a very world-class quality education. Yeah. So those are advantages that are that I would advise students like to come to Russia mm-hmm. and like seek their quality education.
Mm-hmm. So my next question is about the Russian language. How did it go when you started studying it?
Yeah, well, as for me, like before coming to Russia, I have luckily like been studying Russian like for 6 months before coming
okay.
to Russia. So, okay. So, and like that was my push. So when I came into Russia, mm-hmm. after 6 months, I was speaking Russian language. So like,
okay.
yeah,
okay.
many students came to Russia, but they are not just able like to speak Russian language because they were not prepared and like lack of information. We are now giving out such information
yeah.
like to prepare
yeah.
students
yeah.
like
sure.
before coming to Russia, try and prepare yourself,
sure.
try and like learn the basis of like Russian language, so as you come it's going to be easy like for you to get yourself rolling and get yourself integrated in the Russian
sure.
life.
Sure. Okay, so guys, you heard it. Is it difficult to learn the language?
I won't say that it's difficult. I will never say that because nothing like it's difficult. It just take personal interest of a person. If the person really want to learn it, and if the
yeah.
person have that passion of like learning
yeah.
language,
yeah.
I think maximum of like 1.5 years,
mm-hmm.
they should be able like to speak Russian.
Okay. Okay.
At a business level.
Okay. That is it. So let's talk about working. Working.
Yeah.
I know you are working here.
Of course, I'm working.
Yeah, legally, you are working here.
And I'm also doing several businesses also.
Good.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you can enlighten something small about what you are doing here so
mm-hmm.
that people will see that international students can work here.
Mm-hmm.
Do you understand?
Mm-hmm.
They can do some other things here that will give them money.
I think for the issue of working, it's a very, very sensitive topic that...
Mm-hmm.
I think it's the first question that the student try to process.
Mm-hmm.
How can I work? Like, if I have to compare China and like Russia, like in China, students cannot work.
For sure.
And like in like many other countries, students cannot work. But here in Russia, there are some myths that students cannot also work. Those are a big fat lie. I will tell you that
mm-hmm.
students, you can work legally.
Yeah.
Like once you have the Russian or working permit now.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, wow. I'm really impressed with your explanation.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So what about the weather? Yeah, the weather. People have been asking, can you enlighten us more, like just say
yeah.
something about the weather, your experience?
geographically, yeah. Russia, we are far from the equator, so like Russia is a very, very cold country. Like, yeah. Our average temperature that we experience here during winter is like minus 20, which is very, very cold,
yeah,
for an African. But I don't think that should hinder, or like that should be an obstacle for,
yeah,
you,
yeah.
If you really seek knowledge, if you really seek quality education,
yeah,
if you really try and put your stuff,
mm-hmm,
together, I think,
sure,
there are many quality clothes and like good clothes that,
yeah,
you can wear and like put on and like,
yeah,
in the weather, it won't be a problem,
yeah,
for you. As for additional information, in the Russian school, as you know, in the classroom, they are always heaters,
yeah,
in your hostel they are heater, which is free of charge also,
sure,
and it's not like in China that students have to pay like water bill, heater bill, and like,
yeah, everything,
light,
yeah,
bill, all those things. And here in Russia, fortunately, we don't pay such bills, so
yeah,
I think,
sure, he has explained very, very well, because he has been here for 3 years, he has
of
a lot of experiences, so
of course.
Okay, so my next question is, how do you relate with Russians, and then how does the Russians relate to you when it comes to racism and then other styles, like, are they cool, are they kind to you?
Yeah, so if I have to tell you about that aspect also, I spend 95% of my time here in Russia with the Russians,
okay,
than with Africans, so I have more like knowledge on that question. So let me just start, like, Russians, they are European, so European have their own set of doing things, so
okay,
those are things that you will also have to adapt to and like,
okay,
get used to the,
yeah,
European culture,
yeah,
of like living, you know, like not like shouting, making noise, like,
sure,
be yourself, respect,
sure,
like each other, clean your stuff, like,
sure,
and look, we all know, and like we have been here, but on the issue of like racism, to be honest, I haven't experienced any,
okay,
issue of like racism. Our Russians, they are very, very cool going people, and like where they like to help you, very, very jovial.
Yeah,
we have had a lot of fun together.
I'm done with the interview with Enoch. You talked very well, and then you explained things very well. I hope the viewers will understand everything. People in Africa, they are having some bad perception about Russia.
Yeah,
it's,
yeah,
called racist and other stuff.
Yeah,
so
yeah, that's true.
I think with your explanation, it's going to change their mind. If someone wants to pursue a good education, the person should just come and then
like just get to do.
Yeah.
You don't have to listen like to a lot of bloggers,
sure,
lot of stuff.
So yeah,
and just come and get the club going.
Yeah.